Yeah. Oh, okay. All right, our next installment on JP6 Services is going to be how to install an attic ladder.
Okay, some basic tools and materials you're going to need for the installation. This attic ladder, you're going to need a square, impact drill, a regular drill. You're going to need a circular saw, an oscillator. And in this particular case with the oscillator, we're going to need some carbide blades. Carbide blades because the ceiling is plaster. And a regular blade is going to get chewed up really quick trying to cut through that plaster. We're also going to need two by six ties and two single 2x6 ties. And of course, we got our 2x6 studs here that we're going to use to tie into the existing joists that are up in the attic.
First thing we're going to do is we're going to get our stud finder and we're going to find where our joists are on the ceiling. I like this little stud finder because, you know, the LEDs light up right around the center. It shows the entire stud or the width of the stud as you go ahead and search for your joist. Here's our first stud, our joist. The next one should be the 16 inches from there, going towards the left or the right. There it is. There we go. That's about a good spot for the ladder. Looks like it's going to clear the stairwell here.
So I went ahead and identified on the ceiling the edge, the inside edge of where the border or the frame of the attic ladder is going to go. And I found in the ceiling exactly where I want to, where I am in between the joists. So I'm going to put a screw right on the line that I drew, because that's my edge, and that's going to poke up through the attic. And that's going to let me know where I'm going to cut that joist, because I want the joist in a specific spot about 3 inches from the edge of the wall to the edge of the frame of the attic ladder. That's where that's going to go right there. Okay, so there's a screw. I put the screw in right on the edge of where I want to make that cut up in the attic. So I'm going to go in the attic, find that screw, and I'm going to cut the joist to that line. Okay, so now we're up here. We're going to go into the access panel that's up in another room. And we're going to go look for our screw. We know that our attic ladder is going to go somewhere along that wall that's way over there. So I'm going to crawl my way up there, being careful to stand on all the joists as I walk across. And we're going to look for that screw. So we found our screw. The screw is right here. And we know that this is pretty much exactly where we want to put it. We're going to cut this joist and we're going to put the attic ladder between this joist over here and that joist over there. What we're going to do is, after we cut this joist, we're going to put a header across it, a double header, and we're going to put it at the length of the box of the drop-down ladder. Okay, we went ahead and cleared out the insulation where we're going to cut here. Make sure that when you're up in the insulation area and you're moving this stuff around, if you wear a mask, this stuff hurts when you breathe it in. Okay? We're going to line it up right against the joist till I touch the screw. But on this side, there's a nail right in the way. And I'm going to mark it right on the joist. Now I'm going to raise this, put this right where I want it. Now I'm going to mark the joist going up. And I'm going to cut the joist right here, right where I marked it. That's exactly in line with the screw that I put on the line that I put when I was looking up at the ceiling. So the frame of our ladder is 53 1/4 inches, and we're going to add two 2x6s on either side to box this out. So since each 2x4 is 1.5 inches thick, that's 3 inches on one side, 3 inches on the other. So that's 6 inches we're going to add to that 53 1/4.
And that on the inside of those 2x6s that we're going to add is going to give us exactly 53 1/4. I'll explain this in a minute after I box it up. Okay, so I went and put in my support beams while I work here to support where I'm going to cut the joist there. And I put another support over here on the other side. Right there's my line. From this line to the edge of the last cut, that is 6 inches longer than 53 1/4. When I add those 6 inches of wood, with those 3 inches of wood on either side, that's going to give me my 6, and that'll take me down to 53 1/4, and the box should fit in here perfectly. Okay, before you tie in your hangers, you gotta make sure you throw these two screws and grab that joist. Grab that joist that's just hanging out there, right in the middle, and then you can put the other joist right on the other sister, the other stud right on top. There we go. Then you grab your other. To the first floor, and we're going to cut out the ceiling with the oscillating saw that's going to follow the edge of the wood. This will fall right out. Next, we went ahead and cut a hole over here just so we could pass our tools up to the deck. Next, you want to measure the width of the box or the frame of the attic ladder. So we're at 22, that's what we want, 22 inches. We're going to get 22 inches on the other side. I'm going to go ahead and use another tie and tie that into place. Okay, we got our box framed out for our attic ladder, 22 inches by 53 1/4. It should fit perfectly inside the square. We're going to use the oscillator now, that guy hanging out right there. And we're going to follow the oscillator blade all along the frame here and cut this out. We're going to have someone waiting downstairs to grab the panels as they come down. These are cement panels, so we have to use a carbide blade. The normal drywall blade won't work on these kind of ceiling panels.
Okay, we went ahead and put up temporary supports on the short sides of the opening. What we're gonna do is we're gonna grab a ladder, toss it up in there, and it should rest on the supports that we got there.
Then we're gonna go over to the top and lag them in. Okay, we went ahead and put in the attic ladder. It fits perfectly inside the frame. What we did have to do, however, is we removed the bracket screws that are supposed to be used with these, and we ended up using regular construction screws because the profile on the heads are smaller and they allow for this frame to fit in. It's a pretty tight fit. It's a pretty exact fit, actually, into the opening that we made. So then if we had used these screw heads, then this guy wouldn't fit. So we used a low profile or regular construction screws to get it in there, and it went in there no problem. With a little bit of help of a piece of wood and a hammer, went in there. It's perfect. So now we're gonna extend the ladder, and I'm gonna put in the lag screws. Okay, so then I put down a couple just hold down screws. These are just so that I can work with this ladder when I put in the lag screws. The lag screws I'm going to put on the sides. I'm going to put two lag screws going into the frame, into the joist, and then from the frame into the new cross member that I put in over here. So that where I put the screws in, I just tagged one in. One, where are they? Oh yeah, right here. One there, one here on the end of the ladder. And then on the same thing on the other side, I put one there and one on the other side over there. So that should be enough for me to be able to remove my temporary supports on the ceiling downstairs, and then I can bring the ladder down, and then I can access the side so I can put in the lag screws. Okay, we went ahead and installed our lag bolts. We put a lag bolt on this hold down plate, another lag bolt on the hold down plate where the hydraulic pump is at. And we put four across the frame. One, two, three, four. And we put two on either side, on the far edges. On the far side. You gotta move your elbow for a second here. You can see that. There we go. All right. So this guy's installed. Now what we're gonna do is we're gonna check our length on the ladder itself and cut it to where, well, where it reaches the floor. Okay, we already cut the legs on this ladder. They were a little long. So what we did is we measured on the back side. We ran the tape measure from the joint down to the floor, made it a half inch shorter. And then we're gonna remove the legs that came with the ladder, and we're just gonna transfer the legs over here. So we're gonna pre-drill the holes and just bolt them in place. All it is four bolts, two bolts on. There we go, two bolts on each leg. And that's gonna go right here on the ladder. All right, attic stairs are complete. We went ahead and put the casing up. That's what makes it look pretty. So this attic stairs was actually, what's the word I'm thinking of? Salvaged from another home that was demolished, and decided to keep the attic stairs, and he used it on another home that he owned. So. We went ahead and wiped it down. That's only water on the ceiling there. A little bit of paint. This thing will look great. Here's our stairs. Let's go ahead and pull this guy down. Okay. That's it, man. Attic stairs installed. Put it away. Okay, so I had a couple questions come up about what if I'm installing an attic ladder on a ceiling that's actual lath and plaster, and you have to remove that joist. How do you remove that joist without damaging or bringing down or separating that lath and plaster from the rest of the ceiling? Well, this is how I approached this problem, and it seems to be working out really well. Okay, so here we have an actual lath and plaster ceiling. Let me get the light here so you can see a little better. There we go, lath and plaster. So the way I approach these issues here, not really an issue, that this type of installation, so I grab the oscillator and I just slide it here right in between the plaster and the 2x6. And what I do is I cut the nails all along the length of where I'm going to install the attic ladder. So I already cut the joist here. When you get to the joist, and you know, when your circular saw is only go so far, so you have to actually finish the cut with a handsaw. And the way I do this with a handsaw is very light application. You let the saw do the work. You just pull it back and then keep going back and back. Just the cutting is only gonna happen in the backstroke, because it's really hard to get it in the forward stroke. So you go in, pull back on it, and you just keep going back until you reach all the way down to the top of the ceiling. Okay.
So I went ahead and ran the oscillator along the entire length of the 2x6, and over here at the connecting joint. This used to be they want to convert, and it was an access panel into an attic ladder. So I'm just removing the old frame, and I ran the oscillator down the edge here to cut the nails, and I ran the oscillator along the length, and it just comes right up, no problem. You can see where we cut. I cut all the nails with the oscillator, and the plaster, the lath and plaster, is completely intact. There's no cracks in the ceiling.